Hi, this is Dr. Akkerman, and in this lecture for Music Business, we're going to talk about touring. Now, in recent years, a lot of people in the music industry have complained that record sales are way down, and that's really hurting the music industry. But one area where the music industry is not hurting at all is in touring, live concerts. Attendance and the money being made is way up. In 2008, the concert touring business made $4 billion worldwide. But besides the artists, there are lots of other people that can make money from this touring business. And I want to explain some of those to you right now. The chief executive officer in charge of all aspects of a tour would be the personal manager. Now, there may be an actual tour manager also, but that person would probably answer to the personal manager. So that's really who's in charge. But what that person is responsible for is taking care of transportation, for instance, getting everybody and everything to all the different locations that will be part of the tour. This might mean tractor trailers for all of the equipment. It might mean buses for the people and the staff and the artists. It might mean airfare. Another aspect the personal manager takes care of is hiring the support crew. This is the sound crew, the lighting crew, roadies, stagehands, all of that. They also are going to be booking the hotels or wherever it is everyone's staying. Again, if it's a smaller group, you may only need a handful of rooms. Large super groups are sometimes need the entire floor of a hotel. They're also going to collect some of the money along the way. Other people might help with this, but they are ultimately responsible with making sure that the money they were expecting to be handed over is indeed handed over. There are kind of mythical stories about certain managers back in the 70s who would even carry a gun underneath their armpit, and it was known that you better pay up. They were serious about their job. The personal manager is also going to deal with promoters at each venue. We'll talk a little bit more about what a promoter is in a moment, but each one of these promoters works with the personal manager in every city that is visited. And then also, there's just fires to be put out all the time, and the personal manager is constantly attending with every little issue that might pop up, especially to keep the artist happy. If you can ever watch that wonderful This Is Spinal Tap movie, there's an amazing scene where one of the artists is horribly confused and upset because the deli meat on his backstage catering tray doesn't seem to fit the size of the bread they've been given, and he just doesn't know how to deal with the difficulty of that. And the personal manager is the one who talks him through it. That might be an exaggerated example of the kind of things that could happen. Another person involved with touring is the agent. All right, well, the agent is going to work with the personal manager and perhaps with the artists and actually book the locations that the band, the artist, will visit throughout the tour, and they create the itinerary. Where are they playing, at what venue, and on what day? And of course, they want to do a good job of trying to plan an itinerary that makes the most sense, saves the most time, and thus saves the most money. For unestablished artists, the agent has to be the one who's going to really aggressively go out and contact the promoters and saying, hey, you've really got to let my act be a part of your venue and perform at your location. You'll make a lot of money. Here's our track record. For an established act that's already got a great track record, it's the promoters that will be contacting the agent saying, please let us put your act in our venue. The agent will collect a deposit from the promoter, and this is usually about 10% of whatever the total fee will be, and they'll collect this 3 to 5 days before the actual event. So if the artist is due $10,000 total during the week before, they'll get maybe a $1,000 check as a deposit. If something goes wrong and the event gets canceled, the artist usually gets to keep the $1,000 deposit. The agent also is going to be in charge of delivering the contracts that will include the rider, R-I-D-E-R. And that stipulates all of the specific needs that the artist has. Some of them are very practical. What type of music equipment might be provided by the promoter that's too big to travel with. what type of transportation needs might they need from the hotel just to the venue, things like that. But then there are all these mythical reputation things that we hear about, these stories that, well, some groups insist on having the brown M&Ms removed from the jar of M&Ms on the countertop. That actually did happen. It was in a rider from Van Halen once upon a time. You can go to a website, smokinggun.com, and see examples of amazing riders that have been collected and sent in. Another person involved in the whole process of touring is the business manager. For larger acts, this person is in charge of all of the tour finances. For smaller acts, you know, it might be just somebody who's a part of the band or an immediate friend of the band. And for a larger act, though, you're going to hire a person or an actual company to handle this. They set the budget ahead of time and anticipate how much money the tour should make and how much it needs to finance itself. But hopefully you're always being able to tour and at least break even, or preferably making a profit, right? So you need to set a very good budget to show how that's going to happen. And so things that will be in the budget that the business manager is taking care of is taking care of the payroll for all of these crew members that might be traveling with you. They are essentially employees of the band. The business manager will collect the balance for all performance fees. So the some of the fees may be collected right at the venue by the agent or the personal manager, but fees on the back end will be sent to the business manager, and they'll be taking care of that. And then the business manager needs to make sure that the expenses are being paid. If you're renting a bus, if a hotel has put up extra rooms for all the gas and all the food that's being eaten, that all has to be paid for by the artist, and the business manager is going to be taking care of that. And hopefully your business manager will sound the alarm when too much money is being spent, because you don't want to get to the end of the tour and realize you've actually lost money. Sometimes the budget just gets too high and you've got to have someone sound the alarm. Hopefully your business manager will do that. And now let's talk more about promoters. Well, these are the people in each market area that hire the artist for that event. And this can be someone who's strictly very local. They may also do regional or even national events, but very often you're just dealing with someone in each particular area. And they know the event location intimately, so they know all the nuances of it and how to get in and out and what kind of seating arrangements it has, if it's the right venue for what kind of group. If they're trying to attract a heavy metal group or a jazz group or a hip-hop artist, they're going to know which kind of venue in each area would be the best for that artist. And they really only make money if tickets sell. So they're putting a lot on the line. They guarantee the artist that deposit, and then they also decide how much they'll pay the artist after the event's over. And if the tickets just don't sell, well, the promoter has to eat the difference, because they will need to hand over the full amount if the concert has gone through as agreed. Of course, if there's plenty of people and plenty of tickets, then everybody makes money and everybody's happy. But the duties of the promoter specifically would be to book the venue where the concert's held. They'll pay for a lot of the local advertising. They front the money to do that, because for them it's an investment. They're trying to make profit on that investment. And they'll just supervise the overall running of the show. They are available during the show. They try to just help act as a conduit between the artists and their management and the actual location. Ultimately, the artist really should today take responsibility for making sure that their team is all doing everything they're supposed to do correctly. You may feel like a big-time star the first time you get to go out and tour, and somebody's supposedly paying for all your food and all your hotel, and you're traveling in the nicest limousines, and maybe you even fly first class once in a while, and you think, wow, what a great life. Well, you get to the end of the tour, and it turns out you not only did you not make money, you owe money. Everybody else made money. Your management made money. The promoters made money. The events made money. The locations. And you, the artist, the one who actually made everybody buy tickets and come out and see you, didn't make money. You don't want that to happen. You're the artist. You need to make sure you're taking care of the budget, watching over people who are taking care of those things, so that at the end of it all, they've all made money, and so have you. All right, we'll see you next time.